I like Casta, I really do. But there are a few flaws that annoyed me. Let me share my thoughts with you, but the short answer is, it's worth buying right now. I was quite surprised from the settings here. Motion blur, glow, water reflection, AA, full screen on and off, sound sliders, rebindable keys and controller support. Despite all video options, the game is not pretty to look at. After you choose male or female character and naming him or her, it's time to play the game. You're a caster. Your clan sends you to help get rid of infestation of flanks, but in different sizes. This is the story. I feel this is a missed opportunity for something big. The gameplay is what matters here. This is fast-paced third-person shooter. What is different from other games is the speed your character moves. You start with little stamina. With the press of a button, your character starts to run fast, but for a short period of time. After each mission, you receive credits, which you will spend for upgrades. They are pretty straightforward. I recommend first to upgrade dash and super jump. That way, stamina will increase. Your character will run fast for a longer period of time and jump extremely high. Both are the core of fun here. The game reminds me just a little bit of The Incredible Hulk Ultimate Destruction, with one difference, the shooting. Even when you fall from really high, the ground beneath your feet is shaking and making a wave. Well, The Incredible Hulk is more fun, but Caster is fun in its own right. Except with low stamina, you start with just one weapon, a basic laser, but soon you will acquire new ones by finding specific balls. They are not original. The Eruptor is somewhat interesting, but I wouldn't call it a weapon. With him you can raise the ground and is useful a few places. The others are Blast, great type of weapon, Pulse, basic weapon but after upgrading it becomes like machine gun, Seeker, homing laser, Stun, well, stunning enemies, and Orbit. It has two uses. While holding the left mouse button, it forms a shield around you and when it's released, you shoot the enemy. I didn't find it that useful. The projectiles are too slow. With the exception of a rotor and orbit, every other weapon is useful. Fast enemy, stun him and kill him with the seeker. Group of bugs around you, jump high and use blast. With combination of high speed and high jumps, you are up for an adrenaline-filled adventure. The character can even run on vertical walls and on water. You feel like a superhero. It's awesome! The level design is kinda disappointing. Just open spaces with hills or puddles on the ground. In terms of mechanics, it's great. The character runs fast and jumps high. There are some levels filled with lava or toxic gas in the sky and few other specific conditions. But there is not enough variety in the environment. There is one interesting thing. Terrain deformation. With blast you can destroy parts of the ground, but with the raptor you can raise it. It's a ton of fun. The textures are not great also. They are bland. The game was released in 2009, but it looks like something that came out from early 2000s. This applied too for the character you control and the enemies, but don't let this bother you. There are three types of mission objectives in the game. Kill everything, collect energy balls, or kill trees by shooting them. Here there is also not enough variety. Enemies are buffed with different sizes. From small ones that just charge at you to a huge one that shoots you and the game starts to feel like bullethead. Of course, the distant cousin of Sonic uses his speed to avoid the damage. The AI is okay. When you hit some enemies, they run away from you for a few seconds and then again turn towards you. This is easily exploitable and I don't like it. Of course, there are others with different behavior. Overall, I'd say the enemy diversity and AI are fine. Nothing spectacular. In some levels you have to use the surroundings to kill enemies because regular weapons don't work on them or have other requirements. They were fun. There should be more levels like this. Sound design is good. Effects are alright, but the music is fantastic. Punchy, energetic trance that fits extremely well with the fast gameplay. Some are a little more relaxing and slow, but still great. While listening it, I wanted my character to move faster and faster. Great soundtrack. The biggest letdown for me was the length of the game, 2 hours and 38 minutes. If I didn't want to collect all energy balls, the time would be less. When I reached the end, I saw it would be continued and I was like, that's it? The game cost 2.99 euros and I shouldn't complain. I had fun, but it wasn't enough. This is my biggest issue. There are a few mods for the game to extend the fun, so bear that in mind. From the bottom of my heart, I admit I wasn't expecting to have so much fun. Don't be fooled by the bad graphics or you will miss a great game. Some people are saying that this is how Sonic games should look like. What impressed me here is every weapon is useful, some more than others. And this is rare. Perfect controls, fantastic soundtrack, great gameplay, above 60 FPS, but you have some minor for me issues like bad graphics and not so great level design. This is fantastic short game and I highly recommend it.